Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I am going to show you how to create announcements right here in Canvas and how announcements can benefit you and your students, and especially how they can create communication with you and your students. So, for example, here are a couple of examples of announcements that I've done in my other classes. So this is what it's going to look like in the end. If you open up your course, again, this is a course that is already completed. If you go to the left side over here where it says announcements, you will see the announcements that you have created, or if you haven't created any just yet, this will be blank. If you go to the home page, I'll link this in the cards under settings for you right here. This is how you get the announcements on your home page. It's down in settings. If you go back to this video up here, it will show you how to populate those up on the top of the home page, which I think is really helpful for the students to see your most recent announcements every time they log in on that home page. So here are some announcement examples. What I like to do is tell them what's coming up, weekly reminders. So you can see here that I said this is a weekly reminder. Everything is going to be in here. See you tomorrow for class if you are still working on a face-to-face class. But here are some examples of what I've done for online classes. So here's a class that I taught online, and this is a great way to showcase how you can connect with your students even if you're not doing a face-to-face class, you're online. What I like to do is I like to do weekly updates. So this is an example of a weekly update. I put them on YouTube, so that's why you're not seeing it right now because I disabled them. But I like to populate videos in here for them. So I give them a video and they get to see me discussing what we're working on right now, what we're doing, what's happening. Midterm updates, I like to tell them exactly what's happening in a video here as well. Let's see, what else did I do in this class? I like to give them an update. Here's a great way to start with an announcement. I give them a welcome and a course tutorial. So here I created in Screencast-O-Matic, which you can do, and I'll show you here in a second if you have that application in your school within Canvas, which you should, hopefully. I created a Screencast-O-Matic video here that talks them through. I literally take them through how to use Canvas. I showcase it. You can show them your screen. It's a great way for them to kind of understand what you want them to do and how this course is going to function. Here are some other great announcements. If I'm giving them a Zoom link, I will literally say, here's our weekly meetings and our weekly sessions. Make sure you click on this link. I will give that to them. If you're doing Zoom or reminders, I'll give them a reminder. And this announcement is really just to help them know what's going on, what's happening. You can do videos, you can do photos, you can do, just reminders. Here's our first class, links to other, things that you want them to see. Think of it as a great way to communicate with your students on like a message board type versus just a discussion. It's a great way for you to give them information and updates and a way to communicate with them. I will remind you that you don't want to do an announcement every single day. I try to do them either once a week or twice a week, or if we were meeting face to face and now we're meeting online, I will try to do it during the class time. So all you have to do is go over to your announcements tab on the left, go up to the top right, again, that blue button, click add announcement. Same thing here as you have been learning with all of your pages. Create the title, so weekly reminder or weekly check-in, whatever you want it to be, or a announcement or assignment due soon, okay? And then you can type your text in here, so type your message. Again, you can add, which is great. You've probably understand how to do this more and more now. You can add in videos or photos or YouTube links from here, just like you have in other pages. You can create a link to a website where you can just highlight this and click on it here and put your copy and paste your the website link you want them to look at. You can put in images here or go over here to files and images, upload PDFs to them however you'd like. You can do bullet points over here or list numbers or whatnot. Again, you want less text, more bullet points and photos and messages for them and whatnot. Again, you're going to go down here, click what you want, which is probably all sections. You can also choose a file if you want to upload something. You can then go down here and click delay posting. So if you want to go ahead and draft some of these posts and not allow them to be released until a certain date or time, then you can go over here and set the date and the time that you want. I find this handy. I'll make a bunch of them at one time to come out every, Monday and Wednesday morning at 8 a.m. whenever the class was going to be face to face. Or if your class is once a week, I'll draft these for, every Monday morning at 8 a.m. they come out for the students as a weekly reminder with a video for me. So you can delay it and draft it for you, which is super helpful if you're pre-planning. Allow users to comment. What this does is it allows people to comment like a discussion board and reply. If you didn't see the My Discussion Board video, I'll link it up in the cards here for you now. But it allows them to reply and comment on your announcement. All you have to do is click this box. If you don't want them to comment on it, you can unclick it. And then you can also have them that they must post before they see other comments. I don't personally do that on an announcement. I want them to see the comments if they need it, or maybe someone else asked a question and I answered it already. Enable podcast feed. I wouldn't worry about that right now. Allow liking. What that does is allows that little thumbs up, like a discussion board post. They can thumb up and say, yeah, I like that comment or whatnot. I find that it's fun and nice, and it's a way for them to again communicate with each other. And I leave this blank. I let them all like. I just think it's a great way for them to communicate. Okay, and then all you have to do at the end is click save. I will go ahead and save this one because this class is already done. And then you can see right in here, it has all of your message and whatnot. And then this is where they're going to reply, and you can tell if they and they'll like a discussion post. If you made a mistake, you could always click edit and go back in and edit it. And I'm just going to delete this because I don't need it right now. So that's a way to make announcements. Another great way to use announcements is just to remind them, like here I say, your midterm grades are posted. I do a Cahoots game for them. If you haven't checked out Cahoots, go ahead and check it out, Cahoot.com. And then I give them the link here so they can do a practice little quiz that I play on the game. It's interactive. Just a great way to let them know information and to communicate with them, that you've posted some guidelines. I said happy birthday to one of my students down here. So it's just a great way to communicate with them. So if you have any other questions, please let me know. If you have any other video requests, I've been getting a lot lately. I'm going to push some extra ones out this week. Go ahead, just leave me a message in the comments and I'll make a video for you of what you really need right now. So hopefully your messaging and your announcements are going to help you communicate with your students a little bit better, make it more fun and interactive for them. All right, see you in the next video.